boy Pastor Troy, and you're watching hiphop.brunch.com. Y'all know what time it is, baby. It's fresh in the game, in the zone.
HipHopAirbrush.com. Shout out to HipHopAirbrush.com. He was in the building, you know what I'm saying? Body painting chicks all weekend long.
HipHopAirbrush.com.
Anyway, it's your boy, Airbrush Assassin. You know, log on to the website, HipHopAirbrush.com. Join this movement. Be a part of this movement. Let's make things happen. Peace.
Definition of art and design of hip-hop is a celebration of the visual impact of hip-hop. Everybody knows about rap music, but not a lot of people focus on hip-hop as a visual movement. So I worked with a group of people called The Drawing Board, and we did tons and tons and tons of classic album covers.
Well, the one thing about Say that I think we all admired was that he was one of the first ones to really realize the commercial potential of the art form outside of being just the graffiti artist. It's about providing a service that would actually help propel, you know, the idea of the graffiti artist as the designer.
Very early on, I got a chance to work with Russell, and I did some of the early designs for Fat Farm. And in addition to that, when Puffy started Sean John, he came to me and my team at the drawing board, and he said, I need a logo. And that led to a whole world of opportunities in fashion. One of the things that I learned early on was that we collectively are responsible for this movement. And so putting this book together, one of the things that I wanted people to understand was that we can make anything that we want to make, we can create anything that we want to create. And that's where the title Definition comes from. I am the definition of hip hop. You are the definition of hip hop. We are the definition of hip hop.
It combines original, like ancient Egyptian hieroglyphs. It combined a variety of indigenous art forms and techniques into this modern urban day expression.
There's another way to express that energy, to explore their creativity, and to be expressive in your neighborhood without the negativity.
Yeah, it's very important to be able to bring up the young generation. This is the only way this is going to continue on a good level.
It's real important because, you know, this is culture, and you gotta make sure that people now are, you know, they're really getting away from it, and you gotta bring them back to what their culture used to be.
Thank you.
The only way to be happy, you can try it out. If you go in the corner and you get a mean face, like you come with an ice grill and you come like tough and all that, people will treat you tougher. They'll treat you the way you treat them. If you come out smiling and you're that happy person, everybody will want to be around you and they'll be happy back. It's a small example, but everything in this world is a manifestation of what you give the world. There's the laws of karma are in every scripture. They're in the Bible, the Quran, the Torah, they're in the Yoga Sutras, they're in every prophet told you the same thing. It is really what you give the world that you get back from the world. Not that you have to trade, but give the world the positivity you want back. And this, you have to have faith that that's what's going on, that's how it's going on.